this is well wrapped up. Is it all right to open it up and see what we've got?
Like Christmas, isn't
it? Yeah.
Oh.
Tell us about this.
Well, this is an opera phonograph.
Okay. Mm.
This belonged to my father, and it has been in the family about 40 years, and I inherited it 11 years ago when Dad passed away.
Right.
He collected phonographs and gramophones. Okay. He passed the gramophones to my brother Mark, and he passed all the phonographs to myself.
To a certain extent, you got the better end of the deal there, I think.
The phonograph was invented by Thomas Edison in 1877 and played cylinders, unlike the gramophone, which played flat discs and was patented 10 years later.
I can tell you this, the Edison Opera is pretty much the top of the range that Edison produced, and these are not commonplace at all. Mm. So it's quite a thing to have one of these in the shop.
My father, he had 40 to 50 machines in his entire collection, and his pride and joy was the opera.
What was his name?
Gilbert Fury.
Gilbert, I think I knew him. I think I used to have a shop doing these in London in the 1980s.
Ah.
I definitely didn't sell him this, but I think I may have sold him a few cylinders.
I'm sure you did.
Oh, so this was his. Shall we have a look inside?
Yes.
Oh, blimey. That's a big two-spring motor in there. Absolutely marvellous. You could run a small car on that.
The speed isn't constant, so if that could be looked at, that would be great. One of the main parts, though, is the horn. He managed to fix this onto here with sticky tape.
Oh, OK. So how did it get broken, then?
Well, it was in position in the lounge, and a very small group of children came along who were exceptionally inquisitive, and the horn got knocked off.
Oh.
Oh. Nothing to do with you.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm too young to remember.
So, Tom, have you ever heard this working then?
Oh, I have. I used to sit on my grandpa's lap for hours and hours on end, just absolutely transfixed by all these cylinders, all these machines that I'd never seen before.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it was ace. It's probably where I got my love of music from.
The opera was his pride and joy.
Right.
Well, if this was his favourite one, we'd better make sure that we do a really good job on it then, hadn't we?
Thank you for bringing it in.
Thank you.
OK? And we'll let you know how we get on.
Thank you.
Cheers,
thank you,
Tim.
See you soon.
Okay.
Take care now.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Now let's see if it actually works. Well, we've got it to work again.
Yeah,
that is quite remarkable, actually. So what is this disc, then? Is it wax?
No, it's actually made of celluloid. Edison amberols, as they were called. It's one of the very first forms of plastic.
Oh, can I have a look at it?
The earlier ones were made of wax. But, yeah, try and...
How would you know that there was... Oh, I see. It looks like there's, like, a record, but...
Yeah, the groove starts at the edge, and instead of on a flat disc where it would start at the edge and spiral into the middle...
Yeah.
With these, you start... Start at one end and it just goes round and round and round.
Well, have you got much more to do it, Tim?
Well, there are a couple more things to do. There should be a pointer that indicates a series of numbers there.
Right.
To tell you when it's doing the right speed. But of course, not much point in having a pointer if it hasn't got any numbers to point at. We need somebody with a good eye and a very steady hand to paint a series of stripes and the number 160 on there.
Do you now?
We do. I do.
I'll give it a go for you. Yeah,
you're a diamond.
Absolutely.
You're a diamond.
The stripper has done a fantastic job at getting that nasty layer of varnish off, but there's still quite a lot of purple in the wood surface itself. So I'm working my way around with a really soft grit sandpaper until that purple comes out.
Tim?
Kirsten, you've never done it already, have you?
I have. I can now breathe.
Let me come and see. Oh, that is splendid. Oh.
Is that all right?
Yes. That's brilliant. Oh, Nikki is going to be so impressed when she sees this. Her dad never saw it look like that.
Well, it was pretty damaged in that particular place, wasn't
it? It had been, I imagine, the original pointer must have dragged across there and scratched it all off.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I suppose I'd better make a new pointer that doesn't do that then, hadn't I?
Absolutely.
Shall I take it away?
Please, thank you.
Right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Tim is making a pointer for the speed dial.
The thing about the Edison Opera is they're so rare that the parts were only used on this one machine. So getting a spare one just doesn't happen. So the only possible solution is make it myself.
Now that Will has restored the horn, he's able to glue the two parts back together.
That's pretty good to me.
And the phonograph is almost complete.
There we go. I'll just pop the cover back over so that we can see what it actually looks like. And there we are. It's always nice to put the cherry on the top, isn't it? Let's just open her up and see if you can spot any obvious differences.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my word. That same horn?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
It is the same horn. This is what it should look like. This is what was always waiting underneath.
That's amazing.
I'm absolutely speechless.
Yeah. I mean, what do you think your father would have thought if he could ever have seen it look like this?
He'd be just totally, totally thrilled.
It does look something.
He would be just over the moon. He'd be smiling from ear to ear, wouldn't he? That is just incredible. Can I just turn it around so I can have a look? Wow. But just looking at the wall again, can you see how it's actually constructed?
Yeah.
It's all in pieces.
Because I couldn't tell this before. I didn't know this was under.
Yeah, I really am gobsmacked. That is just...
That's amazing.
...beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful.
I'm sure Grandpa's sat there on cloud nine with a big grin on his face now.
Shall we try playing a record on it now?
Yes, please.
Be rude not to.
Oh, wow, that's absolutely perfect.
That sounds much better.
I can see Grandpa standing there.
Definitely.
Singing and conducting.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Really sum up what I feel. Very happy. Act upon it if you can. I was feeling exceptionally nostalgic. Also uplifted in a really, really lovely kind of way. I'm just absolutely amazed. I really am gobsmacked about what Tim and Will have done to the opera. It really has been brought back to life. I feel so humbled. I'm so thankful